Mega Cebu's vision: a vibrant, equitable, sustainable, and competitive environment that embraces Cebu's creativity and its cultural, historical, and natural resources with strong citizen participation and responsive governance. Part of achieving this vision is to prepare the old Cebu to accommodate the new developments ahead. The old Cebu refers to that part of the city which developed during the Spanish period. This is divided into three districts. The ancient Cebu or Antiguo Cebu is located in the San Nicolas area, where the natives of the island were the first to embrace the Catholic religion and to submit to the Spanish sovereignty. The Parian, which emerged as a result of the mestizo Chinese community, and the Spanish colonial district or ciudad, where the Spaniards settled and where Cebuanos were banned within its borders. These three places that existed at the same time were established within the norms of the Indies and embody the first European settlements in the Philippines. Collectively, they comprise Cebu's historic district. Traces of the history of Cebu remain through the heritage sites and structures that remain in the present day. The Spanish colonial city and the Parian became the heritage core, classified into 9 precincts. The waterfront precinct, where the Port 1 building exists, the Plaza Independencia precinct, where the Plaza Independencia, the Cebu Customs House, and the Fort San Pedro still exist. The Maritima precinct, where the ruins of the Compañía Maritima and the old warehouses still stand. The Commercial Core precinct, which lies at the heart of the original Spanish colonial grid system and shows the precisely laid out rectangular city blocks. The Cathedral precinct, which includes the old convent, the Plaza Hamabar, and the Patria building. The Santo Niño district, Plaza Subo precinct, fronting the City Hall with the Magellan's Cross. Chinatown precinct, with buildings built between 1920 to 1950, representing the most complete association of historical buildings within the waterfront district. The Plaza Parian precinct, with a Cebu heritage landmark, where the Casa Gorardo, the Yap Santiago House, and the Jesuit House of 1730 still exist. Also included in this precinct is Colon Street, the oldest street. Most of the heritage structures of the San Nicolas area were destroyed during the Second World War, except for several old houses. Some sites, however, maintained their historical presence despite physical changes throughout the years. The San Nicolas Church, the Pasil Fish Market, and the Taboan Market. San Nicolas is also known for a historical event, the revolution known as Tres de Abril, which is commemorated by a simple marker along the Tres de Abril Street. With the plan of MCDCB to create a new land use and transport plan for Metro Cebu, a third bridge had been envisioned connecting Mactan to Cebu through the San Nicolas area along the Pahina River. This comes with plans to widen some roads to facilitate a more efficient traffic system. The heritage sites and structures will be protected by law. The dense residential zone will be consolidated to free up space for development. A park will be provided beneath the bridge to provide open outdoor recreational space. The rest of the consolidated land will be used for mid-rise housing to accommodate the projected workforce of the rehabilitated commercial districts. Public facilities which have historical significance will be enhanced. The proposed designs possess the attributes of Mega Cebu, cultural and historic. San Nicolas will retain their identity, their heritage, enhancing it and showcasing it to the public. Innovative, creative, and competitive. The ground floor spaces facing the busy streets are commercialized, giving priority to small business entrepreneurs. Fisherman's Village for low-cost housing and middle to upper middle-income housing units. Inclusive, equitable, and livable. Parks for recreation, basic goods are within walkable distance, natural surveillance keeps the streets safe and secure. Interconnected and compact. The bridge connects Cebu to Mactan. Connection to the waterfront district opens opportunities for economic and social activities. Streets are designed to be walkable. Green. Linear Park protects the river. Main Park provides recreation. Pocket parks encourage community activities. Integrated, coordinated, and participative. Community involvement in defining the streets for each block. The character of the historic district will be its main catalyst for a vitalized community that will contribute to the vision of Mega Cebu, thereby making Cebu a vibrant, equitable, sustainable, and competitive environment. Mega Cebu, making waves.